This is a Swedish steel blade. I'm going to set the bevel using a 1000 grit king. Takes just a few strokes. Okay, set the king aside. Rinse off the blade. And I'm going to carry the camera over to my microscope. This is what the scratch pattern looks like from a 1000 grit stone. Notice how the scratches are very long and they go all the way up to the edge of the blade, showing that that's a correctly set or fully set bevel. I'll take a photo of it. Okay, pull the blade back over to the sharpening bench. Set my camera up again. Next I have here is a relatively soft Asagi stone. It's a medium hard in the 5 range. Not a very hard stone at all. I'm going to raise a slurry using a diamond plate. You can see how easily the slurry is created. So this is a worn out Atima diamond plate, number 600. Okay, so I'm going to establish a scratch pattern, and I'll do a minimum number of strokes. Okay, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That was just medium pressure. Rinse off the blade. Go back over to the camera or the microscope. So this was with 5, maybe 4-inch strokes. And you can see how the scratch pattern has evolved here. This is what it looked like with 1000 grit scratches. And then this is what we're at after just 5 strokes with a slurried Japanese natural stone. Okay, so I'm gonna go back over to the sharpening bench. I'm going to add just 5 more strokes. You can see how this stone has dried out already. It's not a hard stone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's 5 more. Rinse off the blade. Back over to the microscope. This shows you how wide the bevel is on this razor. There's the base of the bevel. This is what a bevel looks like at 800 magnification. Okay, so this is the edge. Focus it in. Essentially, all of the 1000 grit scratches are gone. You can't see any of those long diagonal scratches anymore. So I'm going to take a photo of that. Next, what I'm going to do, I bring the Oh, just remember, that was with 10 strokes. Okay, I'm going to set this stone aside and bring in this Karatsu stone. This is very hard. This is in the level, I would think, 5+, 5++, somewhere that type of hardness range. So you'll see the stone doesn't give up slurry that easily either. Okay, I'm going to use the same technique. Actually, I need to reset the bevel, just like before on this king. Rinse off that blade, and just for sake of transparency, I'm going to go back over to the microscope and we'll just view that scratch pattern so that we're all on the right page here. Okay, here we begin. We have another 1000 grit scratch pattern on that blade. Pretty much the same as before. And I took another photo of it. Okay, back to the Karatsu. Get this out of the way.
So-called Mighty Five, handful of Russian composers, and when he wrote this work, it was shortly after the...
Here is my Atoma, and you'll see how difficult it is to raise a slurry on this stone. I'm pushing down real hard, and we did end up with a milky slurry. Okay, I'm going to do the same procedure, just 5 strokes. Rinse it off. That was 5 strokes on that stone. There's a faint shadow of one of the original 1K scratches left, and that's it. In 5 strokes, 99% of those, remember that whole edge was filled with those 1K scratches. 99% of those scratches are gone in just 5 strokes. Bring this. We'll just repeat the process here. See, people who don't have a microscope don't realize at the micro level how quickly these scratches are removed. Okay, 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. Rinse it off. Here's that same edge. Now we're not looking at how sharp the blade is, we're just looking at the scratches. There are no scratches from that 1,000 king left. Take a photo of that. So that just goes to show how quickly a slurried scratch pattern is removed. Helps to remove those 1K scratches.